Back in October, much was made of Adam Greenberg's return to Major League Baseball. In 05, during his very first at-bat, facing his very first pitch, Greenberg was drilled in the head by a fastball. 7 years later, the Marlins allowed Greenberg to take his second at-bat. He struck out on three pitches. Travis Roy should be so lucky. Like Greenberg, Roy had his athletic career cut short just moments into the fulfillment of a lifelong dream. Christine Simpson has his story.
Sports and life can sometimes be cruel. Just ask Travis Roy, who 17 years ago received a brutal blow from both. He was living his dream, a heralded rookie on Boston University's hockey team, eyeing a career in the pros. Then, just 11 seconds into his first shift of his first college game, he crashed into the boards, leaving him paralyzed below the neck. How does one react to such a cruel twist of fate? Well, Travis Roy's response just might surprise you.
I was 20 months old. My dad managed local ice arena, found a pair of skates. My first pair of skates were actually figure skates because that was the smallest pair I could find. Yeah, I got a little bit of a head start on competition and, you know, sort of being growing up the rink rat, and I loved it. It was my passion.
That passion for hockey was going to take Travis Roy all the way to the NHL. At least that was his plan. October 20th, 1995, he was about to achieve the first goal he'd set for himself when he earned a spot with the Boston University Terriers.
It was a dream come true. I'd worked hard to earn that college scholarship and just have my parents there and some friends in the rink and opening night and raising the national championship banner. And there was just a lot of anticipation, a lot of energy, a lot of excitement. And it was a dream come true, and it really was.
But then, 11 seconds into the first shift of his first college game, Travis Roy's dream would end.
I know you've done this many times before, but take me through the moment that changed your life.
I skated in there just as fast as I could, and opposing defenseman picked up the puck, and I thought, you know, I'll just deliver a big shoulder check. And I just didn't hit him as squarely as I'd hoped, and I lost my balance. I hit my head on the boards and just flopped to the ice. And initially, I didn't think anything up. You know, I'll get back on my hands and knees. I've fallen thousands of times. I'll get on my skates, and my body just wasn't responding. It was within seconds, if not a minute or two, when I realized that something very serious was wrong. I'd asked one of the assistant trainers to find my dad up in the stands because I literally knew that my life was over as I knew it, that I was paralyzed, and there was something about it that it just, that life was going to be different.
He said something. I couldn't hear him, so I knelt down on the ice, and I said something like, you know, what's up? And he said, I'm in big trouble. I can't feel anything, and my neck hurts. And that was the first time that I was lost for words. I didn't know, you know, I wanted to be positive back to him, and I just couldn't come up with anything. And that, you know, but the main thing, and it's in his book, and I'm sure he said it before, is, you know, he looked me straight in the eye, and he said, but Dad, I made it. And he did. It just was too short-lived, that's all. He deserved a lot more.
The impact of the hit had cracked his fourth and fifth vertebrae, rendering him a quadriplegic. He was in and out of consciousness for the next month, a ventilator keeping him alive. But as Travis Roy spent the next 4 months laying in a hospital bed, hockey was never too far from his mind. A parade of hockey royalty kept his spirits high, even as he grappled with the reality that he would never walk again. And somewhere in all the despair, where one dream died, a new dream emerged, one that would lead him to find a new purpose.
The Travis Roy Foundation was sort of an idea that really was born right in the hospital, again, just looking down the hallway and seeing other families and other spinal cord injured survivors that just didn't have the right wheelchair, the couldn't afford the ramp or the home modification so that they could go home from the rehab facility. And that was a big part. I wanted to help provide those resources, the adaptive equipment. And so half the money raised goes towards adaptive equipment. And the other half of the money we raise goes towards research. If I can play a small role in that, and it gives my life meaning to be able to do the work that we do with the Travis Roy Foundation. It's a lot of time and fundraising, but it's certainly been worthwhile.
Along with the work of his foundation, today Travis Roy makes his living speaking to various groups, spreading his message of inspiration.
You see, I believe in life. There are times when we choose our challenges, and there's other times when the challenges simply choose us. It's what we do in the face of those challenges that defines who we are. More importantly, who we can and will become.
Have you ever sort of sat there at any point throughout this journey and just thought, why me? Why did this happen to me?
I don't play that game very often. There are times where I have moments where I kind of wish, wonder what would have happened if I hadn't had the injury, and could I have made it to the AHL, the NHL, the Olympics? Again, I'll never know that, and that'll always kind of, it would have been nice to be able to answer those questions. I've tried my best to deal with this challenge and make the most of it, and we're getting there. And there are tough days, and but I have my family and I have my friends, and like the support system that I have continues to carry me.
In addition to his public speaking, Travis is an author, having written the book 11 Seconds, detailing his experience. The Travis Roy Foundation has raised millions of dollars towards aid and research of spinal cord injuries. And as you might expect, Travis Roy is determined to one day find a cure. To learn more, go to travisroyfoundation.org.